I'm Riley Rackliff, a graduate student in the Hooverman Lab in the Department of Forestry and Natural Resources at Purdue University. Like many of you, I use pesticides around my home to protect against insects that might damage my house or my yard, or even bite me or my family. I also depend on the pesticides used on fields all over Indiana to grow the food that keeps us all going. Some of these insecticides inevitably end up washing off our fields and homes and into the ditches and gutters during rainstorms. These, in turn, feed into our lakes and creeks where they can have unintended consequences on harmless aquatic insects. My research focuses on how commonly used pesticides impact sensitive aquatic insects. Aquatic insects play an important role in decomposing dead things like leaves that fall into the water this time of year, as the insects break down and eat plants. They in turn become food for larger organisms like fish, salamanders, and even birds. Too much pesticide in the creek can kill the most sensitive aquatic insects like mayflies and caddisflies. Even if the pesticide is too low to kill them immediately, it can weaken them and increase the rate at which predators eat them. To keep pesticides out of creeks, always follow the instructions on the container. Don't spray near water or ditches, and don't dump leftovers in the gutter, where they will wash into the creek. Healthy aquatic insects are essential to maintain a healthy stream ecosystem, which keeps our water clean and our environment healthy. That's good news for fish, good news for aquatic insects, and good news for all of us.